I bring you greetings from Bison Hill. I want to encourage you today. You've done great. I've received notes from students and faculty about this transition online, and listen, everyone has prioritized excellence. So thank you for pursuing excellence in online learning. I am confident in the creativity of our faculty, as well as the quality of our technology resources. Also, you should take advantage of a new portal that we have made available for you. It's on the OBU Coronavirus webpage, and it's called Virtual Services. The information is here on the screen for you. What it does is it provides a variety of virtual services for our students as we are online. Now, last week, you received information concerning credit for housing and for meals for the remainder of the semester. Thank you for reaching out to us, and thank you for your patience as we made those determinations. I want you to know, we have done the absolute best that we can to provide you with the highest amount of credit possible and still take care of our commitments. You should have already received an email about it, but if you have questions, feel free to reach out to us and we'll be happy to help you. Now, I want to invite you to join OBU on social media, and I want you to watch for notifications telling about available resources for you. These video resources will provide encouragement and help for online education, for information on mental health, and spiritual encouragement at our regular chapel time on Wednesday mornings. So be on the lookout every Monday and Wednesday and Friday for these video resources to be made available to you. Now, here's where I need your help. Students, alumni, friends, I'd like us to begin talking together via social media about two things. Number one, how has OBU transformed your life? And number two, how has OBU equipped you for your future? And here's what I'd like you to do. Post a brief video telling that story. Then share it with friends and students and potential students. After all, we have a great story to tell. And as you tell your story, tag OBU so we can hear how your life has been changed here on Bison Hill. We want to hear from you. Now, I'd like to share something that has been dear to me over the past few weeks. It's a passage from Jesus' teaching. It's from his Sermon on the Mount. Not long ago, I was with several of our OBU students on a go trip to Israel, in the general location where the words that I'm about to read were spoken. It was in this sermon that Jesus gave this teaching. And it's here in Matthew chapter 6. Listen to what Jesus says. He says, "Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, 'What will we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or what shall we wear?' For the Gentiles seek after these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them all." Listen to this. "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Therefore, don't be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious about itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble." Man, what a word for today, isn't it? Isn't it true that you and I have multiple worries pressing in from every side, even right now? We worry about our classes, and we worried about this online transition, and we're worried about our communities and our country, and how long is this going to last? Worry, 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 worry pressing in on every side. But you know, Jesus' words give me great comfort. When we prioritize and seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, listen, Jesus will take care of the rest. Each day has trouble of its own. Don't worry about tomorrow. Focus on Jesus today. And what that has done for me in this time is really cast my priorities on the right things, trusting Jesus, leaning on him. And can I just encourage all of us in these days? Let's trust in Jesus. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Let's not worry about tomorrow and worry about things that are outside of our control. What can we control? Be faithful to the Lord Jesus today. Be faithful to him in our devotional life. Be faithful to him in our studies. Be faithful to him in the everyday of life. Listen, and he will take care of the rest. So can I encourage you in that today? It's been helpful for me. I pray it's been a help for you. But right now, what I'd like to do is just offer a prayer for all of our OBU community. Would you pray with me? Our Father, we thank you for the life that we have in your Son. We thank you that even now we are bound together by your Spirit. Those of us who have professed you as Lord and Savior, you have given us your peace, that we can seek first the kingdom of God and your righteousness, and everything else will be added to us. Lord, you will take care of the rest. I pray this same peace will be for our students, for our faculty, for our staff, for our alumni, for our friends, and for a world that desperately needs hope and peace today. Let us find our peace and rest in you. And Lord, let the worries of tomorrow recede in light of the faith that we have in you today. Thank you, Lord, for providing your word. And I pray, Lord, even as we move into the next weeks, I pray, God, that you would continue to provide your peace and rest for us. In Christ's name that we pray these things. Amen.